What's going on, everybody? Welcome to GMI's World. Today, I'm going to show you how to formulate your best scheme using the new Audible on the Fly mechanic, all right? So pretty much what the Audible on the Fly does is every game, you're able to set your audibles however you want it. Keep in mind, you cannot save it and it continues to go game to game, all right? Especially with Ultimate Team. If you have it in franchise mode, it's a different situation. I think you can set your audibles to be whatever you want them to be, but I'm going based on Mutt and regular games, all right, like regs. So what happens is, whatever your scheme is, you're going to want to put those best plays in them. So what happens is, when you go to the play call screen, right? Once you're on this play call screen right here, you're going to press the left trigger. The left trigger is going to show you the audibles that you currently have. Now, for a lot of these plays, what I'm going to suggest to you is to make sure that you have a draw play and a regular inside zone play for these shotgun plays. Primarily because the draw play is very, very OP, and it kind of throws your opponent off in regards to what you're really trying to do, okay? So depending on what you run, that's something that I would suggest. Like, for instance, the double slants, if you look at the double slants play, right? Let me go to the double slants play. Where is it on this thing? I can't, why don't I, okay, right there, right? You can hot route your slants if you're going to run that in a regular game, whatever like that, or you could come out in double slants if that's something that you're into. Pretty much, people might run slants in the red zone, try to get a quick touchdown. Maybe it's fourth and inches, you go for slants, whatever like that. It's not generally a play that people just come out running, which is why I'm trying to suggest that what I would do is I would look for the draw, and I would put the draw in with the inside zone, so that way you have, you know, it's different ways that you can run your plays. Because if you have a draw play and an inside zone play, it pretty much makes, it's going to change the way the game is. You understand what I'm saying? It's going to definitely 100% change the way your opponent plays you. And I'm going to give you some examples with it right now. So look what we're going to do, right? We saw what the audibles were. So we pressed the left trigger. We saw our original audibles. We're going to press the square button, which is also the X button on Xbox One. And what we're going to do is we're going to put the draw play in there. All right? So now we got the draw and we have inside zone. The reasoning behind this, I'm about to show you right now. Okay? I'm going to come out and I'm going to pick okay, let's go out to YSL, right? Pick a random play for the computer. All right, we look at the play right here. Looking at this defense right here, we could probably assess that R1 is going to be open on this route. It looks like a cover two, right? Because you can see the way the corners are off a little bit, the way the safeties are lined up. I would guess that this is a cover two, unless it's probably like a cover four and they're showing two, whatever it is. So we should know, right, that the R1, depending on what Josh Gordon does, if he gets bumped, R1 might be open immediately on, you know, at the start of the play. Let's look what happens. Okay, so it looks like it is a cover two. He bumps him, but we're not going to get that many yards. It was a cover two, all right? So the reason that I showed you that, to let you see that it's possibly a cover two, was to show you that a draw would probably have worked better against that cover two. Now he's a little bit further back. We don't know if it's cover two. We don't know what's going on, but we also know that he's not there for that decent run support if we hot route and go to a draw. You see what I'm saying? So we can see based on the right side. Keep in mind that this is on all Madden, okay? This is all Madden gameplay. So as you guys know, I usually do all my tutorials on all Madden because the computer cheats and I keep the game style on competitive. Just to give you guys you know, an update about what I'm doing, all right? Now, once you see, right, you see the green. So pretty much when you hike the ball and you're going to run this draw, you can determine if you're going to go right or left. That's why the draw is so essential in this game. If you watch even the pro players, right, they have the draw, they'll come out. Now that they have these audibles on the fly, it's going to be a lot more exciting to see what they do, even though most of them run the same stuff anyway. But now that they can have the draw and inside zone, possibly screenplays, it's going to make their offense very, very difficult to stop. Because You have to now assess for so many things, and it's more realistic, in my opinion, which is why I really like the idea. So now, getting back to the play, right? The reasoning behind always having a draw is this. When you hike the ball right now and you see what's happening, you can choose which way you go, right or left. I chose to go left based on what happened, but I got stopped immediately. Now look, you see how they're down? This looks like a man-to-man type situation, right? Which is why, you know, you have an in route over there. You have Gordon going out on a streak. What you could do, okay, with man-to-man, you can hot route Coleman to an out route. okay? Or you could come out essentially in the hot route formation if your opponent is running a lot of man. You know, obviously you could put Higgins on a cross to make, you know, just looking at the defense, you can figure out what you want to do. So let's see if it is man-to-man. Okay, so it is man-to-man. So we know that out route, it should be open, but it's man, it's all Madden, man-to-man, stuff like that. You could easily put him on a slant if you wanted to. Okay, now we're back to cover two. So with cover two, we could go, you know, four verts, okay? We don't really need to do the complete play action. So I'm going to hot route my running back into a purple, a stop and go route, pretty much by pressing triangle, you know what I'm saying, and his icon and down on the right stick. That's going to make him be a stop and go. He's going to act like he's on a block. Then he's going to go out and run a play. But it looks like cover two, so the seam should be open. Okay, we're looking at the seams. Okay, he ran with the seam. Okay, again, with the way that you look, with the way that you play it, it all depends on what, you know, what your read is exactly. With certain cover twos, right, especially with the way that people run it, especially like pro players, what they do is they put a middle linebacker in a deep blue. But I'm just assessing the different defenses, all right? When you look at this right here, this can be cover two as well. So we're going to leave it the way that it is. Okay, so it is a cover two. So this guy, okay, that was a Stevie read, right? With the way that Vic Beasley was playing it. That was a straight Stevie Wonder read. You don't want to ever do that. But what I could have done on that play is actually wait for him to go outside more and hit the in route on the left side. Okay, more cover two. Okay, so what are we looking for? Okay, I got sacked immediately by the computer. This play right here is probably, okay, let me get out of this play, as a matter of fact, because I'm not actually giving you guys the best example of what I would actually be doing. I just came out in the play to show you, to make sure you have the draw and stuff like that. So based on what they're doing, do they have post routes in this offensive playbook? This is actually right now the Colts playbook. I'm looking for something with like a post route in the middle, because a post route in the middle would more help what we're trying to do right now. But they don't have, it don't look like they have anything like that. Four vertical, do they have four? Let me go. Yeah, wide trips. Wide trips is probably going to be better, because even, yeah, with the four verticals, if they come out playing cover two, it's easier for us to do it. So what we're going to do is we're going to put the draw in. What is that? Hold up. What is this? Is that stick play? Let me see how their stick play is. Yeah, their stick play is like that. Okay. So we're going to take their stick play out. All right. For our audible on the fly. And we're going to put the draw in right there, just so that we can have, it's the same type of thing. And then we're the play action read. Let's see if we like something else. The play action read looks pretty good the way it comes out. But do we like it for this? I don't know. Let me see, because we could actually even like start to get glitchy and put the slip screen in there also. But then we got to rely on one play, and I don't want to have to do that. But for this video right here, for the primary purpose of showing you the best type of audible on the fly plays, all I'm trying to focus on right now with you guys is the halfback draw and the inside zone, and just reading defenses and seeing how you can utilize it to the best of your ability. So we're gonna come out with a play that's not in the audibles. Let's just say slot under, right? We're gonna pick a random play. All right, this is more ideal because this is more of what I really run. So looking at this, it looks like cover two, right? So this is what I was trying to say before. If you want to run the draw right here, the draw is probably gonna get you a decent amount of yards based on what's going on. If you have a decent, you know, whole blocking mechanic. But again, these are the Browns. Now they're down, right? So them being down, this is what I would do. Okay. The inside zone is there. You don't really need to run the draw right here because of the way you can see that. You see this guy that I'm IDing? The left side, he's way outside on the left. So if he comes in for run support, he shouldn't be able to help out as much. We should have been able to get more yards. But again, the block sheds and everything like that with all Madden is OP. All right, obviously right there, they're in goal line, right? So with goal line, you're just going to simply go to four verts. You could actually block Crowell, double tap it, his icon, and press the right trigger, and you should, the guy, it's no way that they should be able to do anything with that. So we're gonna go ahead and drop. All right, we're just looking at the type of defenses that you'll be able to, you know, go against and make good plays on. Now when you look at this right here, the way that they're pressing you and you're down, I'm not sure if it's zone or man, right? So because we're not sure if it's zone or man, we're gonna want to keep Higgins on that cross, on that route like that. We could possibly put Coleman on drag to see what's going on with it and see if Gordon can get separation. Now, Gordon looks like he has a little bit of separation, but it's an inaccurate pass. Obviously, it's a terrible quarterback that we have right now with the Browns, with Kaiser. He doesn't really have, ideal type of quarterback mechanics, right? Which is why I use the worst teams in practice mode, because it just makes you better. Okay, so again, we're going to hot route Crowell to block, and we're going to send him out on the street, because even if they press, he should be able to get off. Obviously, right there, he's not able to get off of a safety, which doesn't make any sense, because Coleman is pretty fast. But you want to make sure that you can do this quickly. Whenever you see people this far down on you like that, and you want to get that separation, you want to be able to make that play. Because ideally, once they're down like that, pressing, whether it's zone or man, depending on how fast your wide receiver is, you should be able to beat the coverage. What you could also do is hot route them to out routes, okay? Because hot route them to out routes, pretty much we know they're not in the cover two. It's one high safety, so it's no way they're in a cover two. You should be able to successfully get an out route off like that, okay? Now, if you only need inches, this is the reason why I'm telling you to keep the draw there. Because the draw, regardless, you're going to be able to get at least, you know what I'm saying, whatever, at least an inch. The draw is really, really wild. Even if you go, just make sure that you're continually tapping X, okay, to try to stiff arm. Because the draw is just glitchy outright. And usually, you're always going to get that scene where you see that it's like green or whatever like that is letting you know that one side is good. I don't care what defense they're in. Unless they come out in goal line, the draw is ideal. Now, having also the inside zone play is huge if you see the left side, too much attention on the left side. Like, for instance, you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If you split the field in half, there's 5 guys on the right side. So I would go press L1, you know, the L1 button, move it over, press X to ID this guy on the right side, and try to run inside zone on him. Now, he's still block shedding like a maniac. The O-line of the Browns is very, very bad. But again, this is the way that I lab, because I want the worst team against, you know, a formidable team. They have a decent defensive line here. So again, when all else fails, you now have the draw play and inside zone. And feel free to make up your own scheme. I'm just giving you an example. If I was going to show you, a real ebook, I would obviously show you my real plays and how I would determine what I would utilize. But I'm just giving you guys ideas on how to be able to read these plays. This right here looks like a cover two. It's not a cover two. Okay, so you're going to hit him with the out route. All right. You're going to want to look and assess. But what I'm recommending is you always have a draw and inside zone in your playbook. Regardless of what you want to do, you want to have draw and inside zone. If you're the kind of guy that runs wham, you're going to want to have wham and stretch. You see what I'm saying? You're going to want to have two different type of plays. Right here, we're going to go inside zone based on the way that it's set up. Now, you see, he's just getting my right tackle or my tight end is just straight garbage. So he's just getting just ransacked immediately. But ideally, if this is a online head-to-head game, you will be making it to the outside. But again, the way the computer is block shedding immediately, it looks like we're safe trying to run the draw in most cases to get yards. Other than that, you're going to want to put your other two most ideal plays in your audibles to make sure it works out for you to the best of your ability, okay? Whichever way you want to do that, that's up to you, all right? However else that goes on. But this is pretty much the primary base of the video, is to make sure that you understand you want to have at least two of those things in your playbook, all right? At least two. Inside zone and a draw I really like. If you like counters, that also can work. But you want to also assess the defense. Again, one high safety. We should go to 4 verticals. You know, have that streak still going. Have that out route going. Have the out route. Out routes are OP. You always want to have an out route once you see that safety high. But again, I don't want to go into a whole other scheme. If you guys want a whole scheme, let me know. Leave it in the comments. I'll put something together for you guys to make sure you start going out there getting wins. Hopefully this has helped you and been informative. I'm going to see you guys and girls next time. One love.